afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni and
Amory Gianni.
And today is Earth Day.
Happy Earth Day.
Happy Earth Day. Like I said in my email, it's kind of a shame that we just pick one day to celebrate the Earth when our ancestors celebrate the Earth, pretty much all the time. But you know what? Hey, we can get back to that. We can reconnect. And so today, what we wanted to do is we wanted to share with you 9 things that you can do to reconnect to the Earth for Earth Day.
Mm-hmm.
And for your health. It's really important. So let's go. 1, plant something. Doesn't matter if you have a black thumb or a green thumb. Beets, carrots. What else are really? Greens. Real easy to plant. If you can't plant those, try sprouting. But just plant something and just watch it grow. I mean, the amazing, one of the most amazing things about life is that you can take a seed that's like this big and it can turn into a massive, massive bush or a massive human or a massive animal. And it's just absolutely amazing.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't expect me to say that.
No.
All right, 2.
Ground yourself.
Yes.
And a few ways that you can ground yourself. One way is, I'm doing it right now, is just be barefoot on the earth. No shoes.
Yeah.
Be barefoot. So walk around barefoot. Walk around in a park. Lay in the grass. Lay your whole body on the grass and spending some time outside. Spending some time in the sun. That'll help ground you too. Getting that sunshine.
Yes.
What else?
Well, do you guys see where we are here? We're in Richmond, which is Richmond, California, and right over here, you might not be able to see it very well, but there is the San Pablo. No, this is the San Francisco Bay. So the San Francisco Bay is right over here. So it's actually really, really amazing. And this is in Richmond, California. Some people say Richmond isn't that cool. I think it's pretty cool. So let's see. 3 is to pick something and to take something from the earth and to just look at it, smell it, like see what it is. Like just walk around nature here. I see mallow over here, which you can eat. There's plantain. Just looking here. And you just pick it and smell it and just kind of like get connected to it again. Your instincts, your real human instincts, that knowledge, that internal wisdom that we really have, it'll just like almost snap back on. Really powerful. 4. Well, this is a good one for you.
Oh, look into an animal's eye.
Yes.
So, I'm looking into Kevin's eyes.
And if you have kids or if you have, family members, you can do it with them too.
I thought this one was mine.
What's that? No. I'll continue. I was just saying. Go.
So your pets, if you have a pet, look into their eyes. If you're out at a petting zoo or, on a farm or something, look into the animal's eyes because they connect with you and you want to connect with them too.
Yes. And if you're at a petting zoo or if you're at a pasture or something, you might see some things you don't want to see either. And so, that's just one thing to look out for. But, this is the human experience here, and we're connected to everything. And everything's connected to us. So there are some ducks over here. I'm going to go try to, stare them down, see what they do to me. All right, so let's see. 5 is start that compost pile. I know you guys, some of you out there, haven't done it. Go out there and just say, hey, today's the day I'm going to start a compost pile. That's it. Just put all your scraps aside. You're eating a lot of raw, healthy foods. You probably have a lot of scraps. Just create the compost pile right now.
Mm-hmm.
Do it. Get it done.
Give it back to the earth.
6.
6 is eat less meat.
Okay.
Did I skip one?
Yep.
It's hard to see in the sun. So eat less meat. I think it was in 2006, I posted it up on Facebook. I don't remember the exact study. Study shows that being a meat-eating society, it's putting a real strain on the environment.
Yes.
Real strain on the environment, locally and globally. So just eat less meat. Eat more fruits and vegetables. Eat more nuts and seeds.
And toxicity of meat versus vegetables, 10 to 1,000 times the amount of toxicity, industrial, chemical, any sort of toxicity in animal-based products because it bioaccumulates. So it's good for yourself, too. It's good for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
7 is look in your trash. Look in your trash and just see what's there. And if you're throwing away things on a regular basis, try to look into ways whether you can either recycle them or you can use them again. Every time we buy sauerkraut jars, we just use them as glasses until they break, and then or we give them away to people, or we just continually recycle all the things that come in that normally would be trash.
Mm-hmm.
8. This one.
Use FreeCycle. So is it freecycle.com? just go to freecycle.com on the internet, and it's a place where if you have something and you don't want it anymore, you can put it up there, and or if they have something that you might want, you can get it. It's just a nice kind of exchange.
It's secondhand, in the number 9 is shop at secondhand stores. So secondhand things are really a great way to eliminate production, or not eliminate production, but drop the strain of production of industry that uses all these different things, chemicals and compounds from petroleum and all that sort of stuff. Even wood. I mean, wood. We want to so this picnic table here, it's made out of wood. We could get this from FreeCycle maybe. I don't know. So I'm sure there's a picnic table on FreeCycle, and then you don't have to cut down a tree. It's still perfectly good. You might need to sand it down or something. But always thinking about recycling. How can I use it? Secondhand stores are great. You can go there and you can get clothing that's already been purchased, it's been given back to someone, and you don't have to go through the whole process, and you don't have to think about the ethics of that anymore, because it's been already it's something that someone would have thrown away. So now you're actually contributing to the benefit or contributing to the regrowth of all the things that use natural resources. Number 10,
spend time at your park. We're at our park right now.
This has nice sap. It smells really good.
Oh yeah? Did it just fall on you?
No, it's just on it's underneath here. It's really nice pine sap. Mm. Spend time at a park. We're here. Take your shoes off. Kick back. Relax. And I'll tell you, the more people are... This was yours. Sorry. Go ahead.
It's okay.
Say it. Come on. I'm sorry.
That's all right.
The more people who are at the parks, the better it is. Here's why. Because, when developers come in, they look around, they're like, hey, there's no one at this park. It's wasted space. Dollar signs, flash through their eyes and things like that. So we got to be at the parks. And we have to be there and we have to show up, because we want to make sure that these things last. And that's absolutely true. So, your question of the day, add to the list. Give us another topic. Give us, we gave you 10 things. Give us number 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Any idea. Be creative. Have fun. Enjoy it. And have a great Earth Day. All right, cool. I think I'm going to go swimming. This is Kevin Gianni and
Emery Gianni.
Together we can change the health of the world one show at a time.